Well, tonight we are still tracking Hurricane Isaias pushing towards the East Coast at this hour. It has now strengthened to a Category 1 storm, and that within just the last 3 hours.
President Trump has issued emergency declarations in Florida and in the Carolinas. Part of the country already saw high winds and heavy rain roll through earlier today. This was the scene at South Carolina's Folly Beach. Even people as far north as New York, New Jersey, and Rhode Island are getting ready for the possibility of winds, rain, and rip currents from this storm.
Right now, it is forecast to make a direct hit on the Carolinas. President Trump urging everyone tonight to be vigilant in this area and follow state and local guidelines. Our Ann Wyatt Little is live at Carolina Beach right now. And Ann, we've been watching you for a little bit here. I saw some transformers blowing. It looks like the winds are picking up even as we speak.
Yeah, it sure is. That transformer that you saw, it's gone off about 3 times just within the last 45 minutes that we have been out here. So conditions certainly taking a turn for the worse, and it's going to be like this until at least we get out of this storm for the next couple of hours. But we're in the northeast quadrant, so we're getting hit with those heavy rain bands and strong winds from this Cat 1 storm. I want to step out of the way, just kind of show you what we're dealing with. You can see the wind really whipping around here. We've got the traffic lights are waving back and forth, or swaying back and forth, I should say, along with the trees. We do see some water out on the roadways here, and there's a McDonald's across from the parking lot where we're kind of sheltered in place for a little bit of protection from the wind. And we can see some of the awnings appear to be ripped off. So really, it's just a matter of getting through these next couple of hours. Storm surge is a concern. Power outages are also a really big concern with this storm. Utility crews are stationed to make their way to make those repairs, but they're working in smaller crews because of the pandemic. So we really just don't know the extent of the damage until the sun comes up tomorrow morning. So we've just got a couple of more long hours to get through. We're also dealing with tornado warnings that have been going off now for about 2 hours. So it is a very fluid situation. One that we're continue to monitor. Reporting live at Carolina Beach, I'm Ann Wyatt Little.
All right. We will let you get back into a safe and secure place. Thank you so much. God bless you guys and be safe out there.
Yeah, for sure. Thanks, Ann.